Welcome back. You're watching Maggie Kitchen Journeys, an initiative aimed at helping you start your kitchen journey. Now let's talk about the most important part, making profits. After all, that's the reason why we started this entire journey and learned finance in the first place. So now that we've come so far, let's not make any mistake in understanding and calculating our profits. It's pretty simple, but knowing and understanding it is essential. So enjoy watching this last segment on finance.
Welcome back. So far, we've done all the paperwork and set up the systems. Why do we do all of this? Well, to make sure your business runs smoothly and your finances are managed well, so that you can focus on your passion, food. While you are taking your brilliant food to the world, you need to ensure that you are making profits as well. Hi, I'm Hansi. I've worked in finance for 20 years and now enjoy working from home to help people like you understand and make money. Profits are fairly simple to understand. You think it's a difference between the price you sell your product at and the cost of materials for making the product. Let's take an example to understand profits and profitability in detail. So let's say you're setting up a business selling cakes. If it costs you rupees 100 to make a cake and you're selling it at rupees 250, your profit is 150. This rupees 150 is actually your gross profit. This calculation does not take into consideration your other expenses such as rent, electricity, gas, marketing, and so on. These costs, other than the cost of your ingredients, are called fixed costs. Say your fixed costs add up to rupees 5,000 a month. You have to include these in your calculation for profit as well, na? For this, we need to use a concept called break-even point. Don't worry, it's not as complicated as it sounds. Break-even point is simply the number of cakes you would have to sell to make sure you are not making a loss. Anything you sell after that leads to a profit. Easy, right? So far, we know it costs you rupees 100 to make one cake, and you sell it at 250 to make you a gross profit of 150. And your additional expenses or fixed costs per month are 5,000. So your break-even point is calculated by a simple formula. Break-even point equals fixed cost divided by gross profit. In your case, this would be 5,000 divided by 150 equals 34. So you would need to make and sell at least 34 cakes to not make a loss. And from the 35th cake, you are making a profit. Good to know, right? Okay, let's take a quiz again to see whether you've understood. So other than your raw ingredients, the expenses such as electricity, rent, and marketing expenses are called A, fixed cost, B, extra cost, or C, opportunity cost. The answer is A, fixed cost. So we've come a long way in this series. We've set up a business entity, got a food safety license, set up a bank account and a payment gateway, registered for paying taxes, put in place a cash flow tracking system, and figured out how to manage our cash flow ensuring profit. That's a lot. If we master these, we can not only enjoy the fruits or profits of our labor, but contribute so much to the nation. Let's do it. Happy to have helped you in this journey. I'm Hansi.
To recap, here are a few key takeaways. Gross profit is the difference between your selling price and the cost of your raw materials. Other expenses such as rent, electricity, marketing costs are known as fixed costs or overhead costs. Break-even point is the number of units of a product that you need to sell to ensure that you're not making a loss. To calculate your break-even, divide your fixed or overhead cost by your gross profit.